In this part, we'll use simple scripting to run repetitive commands. Python skills are not required. Commands will be copied from Info Window and from Python tooltips. Reload startup scene by pressing Ctrl+N, General. Switch to scripting workspace. Grab the cube and translate, scale, and rotate it. From Blender's Python info window, bottom left of screen, multi-select the corresponding three commands by pressing Shift key. Press Ctrl+C to copy. Paste the commands into Python console window, just above it, and hit Enter. All the commands get executed. Repeat a few times. In order to make a script, click New to create a new text file in Text Editor window, and paste the commands there. Run the script by clicking the play button. You will get an error. In order to see error messages, open the System Console window by selecting Window, toggle System Console. In other operating systems, the console has to be started together with Blender, see the manual. Error message says that name BPY is not defined. BPY is Blender's Python module and the script did not load it. Script has to start with import BPY command. Add the missing line, import BPY. Now the script works as expected. Notice that most parameters are defaults and can be skipped. In our case, only the first numeric values define the translation. If you wish to save this Python script, select Text, Save As, and use .py ending. Next, we will find out the Python commands to import and manipulate X3D mesh and to render and save the image. Reload startup scene by pressing Ctrl+N, General. Go to Edit, Preferences, Interface. Enable Python tooltips and developer extras. Switch to scripting workspace. Create a new script and start it with import BPY. Not all commands show up in information window. Import command is one of them. We'll find out the command from its tool tip. Go to File, Import, X3D Extensible 3D. Right-click for copy Python command. Paste it to your script. To find out what should be inside the parentheses, copy the command without the last closing parenthesis to the interactive Python console and press Tab key to autocomplete. Copy and paste to your script. File path, in quotes, and axis directions are relevant. Change forward axis to Y and upward axis to Z. This keeps imported objects' Z axis pointing up. The usual Windows conventions can be used when writing the file path. We'll use an object created with ParaView. ParaView underscore isosurface underscore 01.x3d. This can be downloaded from the link on this web page. Grab and move the default cube to the side, away from the origo. Run the script. We'll need to delete the imported light and camera without using the mouse. In the 3D viewport Windows File menu, choose Select, Select Pattern. Type direct asterisk and remove tick from extend. Repeat, but this time type view asterisk and tick extend. With cursor in the 3D viewport, press delete button. Find and copy these three commands from information window and paste to your script. Delete command does not need any parameters. Delete the last remaining imported object and run the script. The imported object is too large to fit in the camera view. Choose Select, Select Pattern, type Shape asterisk, and remove Extend tick. Scale the object down by pressing S, type 0.2, and press Enter. While at it, choose Object, Shade Smooth from the File menu. Find and copy these three commands from Information window and paste to Script. Delete the Shape object and run the script. Now we have a script that imports and modifies an X3D object. Let's make the code easier to read by defining a variable for the path. Let's also insert some comments. Next, we'll render the scene. Choose Render, Render Image. Image Editor window opens, showing the render result. Note that at this point, the rendered image is not saved. Render command does not show up in the information window, so it has to be copied from the tooltip. Paste it to the script. Paste the first part of the render command to the Python console window and press Tab key to see the parameter options. As an educated guess, the parameter right still needs to be true for the image to get saved. Other parameters are not needed. Render command has no file path nor file name parameters. Output parameters are defined in Properties window, Output panel. Default output path points at TMP folder. Change this by copying the file path from your script, add a name for the image, and press Enter. The default format PNG is better quality than JPEG, but larger. Change file format to JPEG. In the script, this line needs to precede the file name definition. Find and copy the two corresponding commands from information window and paste them to the script just before the render command. Double backslashes are not necessary, singles will do. In the script, define image path parameter similarly to mesh path, but with the file ending JPG, and use it in the file path command. Now we have a script that imports, modifies, and renders an X3D mesh. In order for the script be useful, it needs extensions, which are slightly more advanced, and use some elementary coding tricks. The imported mesh has no material yet. Constructing the material with Python code is not difficult for a programmer, but beyond the scope here. As a workaround, we'll define a material manually for the default cube and share it with the imported mesh using a link. We could switch to shading workspace to work with the materials, but we'll use a faster method. With the default cube selected, go to Properties window, Material panel. Left-click the yellow dot in Surface, Base Color, and choose Input, Attribute. Fill and call for its name. This attribute refers to the vertex colors of the imported mesh, and cube will be storing the material for it. Material can be linked between selected objects. One of them has to be the active object of the scene. Material gets linked from the active object to the other selected objects. As before in the script, use select pattern command to select the cube and the imported object. There is no straightforward way to find out how to make the cube the active object on the scene. A web search would show that the following line does the trick. Delete the imported object and run the script. Now both objects should be selected, shape object with orange and cube with brighter yellow color, showing that the cube is the active object. From the 3D viewport window, choose object, make links, material. Copy the corresponding Python command from the information window to the script. Delete the imported shape object and run the script. Now the rendered image has colors. It is useful to run a procedure repeatedly. In order to start fresh, the imported object needs to be deleted after it is rendered. Copy and paste a previous pattern select command for the shape mesh. Make sure the extend parameter is false to avoid deleting other objects. Then copy the delete command under it. At this point, we have a script that imports, modifies, renders, and then deletes an X3D mesh. We can use this script to render an animation by running it in a loop. The only thing that changes from step to step is the name of the file that gets imported and the name of the saved image. In Python, we may use the following for loop structure. We have three isosurface meshes to render, so the parameter number gets values from 1 to 3. Our loop stops at 4. The double quoted parts in mesh and image names define the format of the number. Here the number consists of two integers, first of which is 0, if the number is below 10. Note that this script presupposes that the scene has been prepared beforehand to include at least a well-positioned camera and lights. The default cube, which should be outside the camera view, holds the material for the object to be imported. Settings active in the Properties window, Render and Output panels will be used. The script has to be saved with the ending.py in order to be recognized as a Python script by Blender. Also note that a good script would erase the imported shape meshes from memory, although this is not necessary in simple cases. Details of orphan meshes are left as an exercise. In more demanding cases, the accumulation of orphan meshes can lead to running out of memory.